Hi, my name is Chelsea Mills. I am a resident of Fenton Township and I own a business in Fenton, Behind Your Design. And I also serve as the chairperson for the Career Connections Committee for the Chamber of Commerce.
Chelsea, thanks for coming out today. So what do you most fear about going out right now during COVID?
Actually, I don't really fear anything going out right now. I'm very comfortable going out and about, and I enjoy to see the businesses that have been promoting that they're following the CDC safety protocols, because that makes me understand and know that their staff is well-versed on it and that they're comfortable receiving customers into their place and they're prepared. And I just think the thing that a lot of people that I've talked to that do have fear about going out, they just don't wanna look silly if they go somewhere and they don't know what rules to follow or what's expected when they go in that business. So I really wanna give kudos to the businesses who are promoting what they're doing to keep their customers and their employees safe.
So Chelsea, I know you and Matt were just overseas in England. What was the expectations over there of businesses for protecting their employees and their customers? And then kind of what would you like to see here being done? And is it similar?
Yeah, so it was really interesting because I was actually kind of nervous to travel internationally because I had heard domestic flights were actually pretty full. International though, it was kind of an essential travel, and the plane was a giant Dreamliner, jetliner, 60 rows, and had 30 passengers and 10 crew members. And when we got to the airport, the safety started there. They were handing out masks. When you walked on the plane, like, all the stores and shops were pretty much closed. It was like it was midnight in the airport when it was middle of the day. In Chicago is where we flew out of. Everyone had masks on, all transportation. Everyone was wiping down everything. It was very, very clean. We get on the plane, they hand you sanitation wipes. The plane was very clean. They asked that you wear your masks. They don't serve anything open, so no coffee, no tea, no alcohol. You could only get bottled water and cans of pop. And that was great. When we got into London, you had to walk through a tunnel and they took your temperature infrared. When you went through customs, you had to fill out paperwork where you were staying, and they said they might come check on you to make sure that you were quarantining, which we were. That was our plan. And then when we were there, we were quarantined at two spots, my brother-in-law and my in-law's house. We had to go between the two of them for what we were over there. And so when we drove by, like, they were very big on social distancing in England. Like, everything was marked out 6 feet. The grocery store we drove by and the people were wrapped around the building 6 feet apart. The restaurants were takeout only when we were there last month. And outside there was markings on the floor for 6 feet apart. They wouldn't let anyone into any businesses. My in-laws told me unless you had a mask on and you had to wait outside, and they let one person in, one person out. So they were very, very controlled over there in the businesses. They did have some of the same issues that we had were the beaches. I'm sure it made global news, the Bournemouth Beach, where they had 500,000 people go. And it was very sad to see that, just a disregard for that. But at the same time, they worked very hard and social distancing and keeping their businesses and their people safe. So it was cool. And then the way back, same thing, 30 people on the plane, 10 crew members. We got back into Chicago. The fire department gave us a health check, took our temperatures, asked us questions, and then we were good to go.
All right. Well, thanks for coming back.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right.